Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today I'm going to talk about Modbus authentication for SCADA system. So first of all, what is SCADA? Anyone have any idea about SCADA? Okay, so it's abbreviation of? Okay. So SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition. So for SCADA networks, it's the foundation for modern world and daily life, like gas distribution systems, like power grids, like water supplies, like traffic control. So mainly, all this kind of stuff are controlled with the SCADA. So what can cyber attack do to a SCADA network? This is a main issue we have to consider. It can cause a great loss for each and everything, okay? So attacks, it is possible to destroy large bombs, for example, by repeatable cycling them on and off, as well as similar attack can take a place by made against generators and other heavy rotating equipment. So the SCADA component, it's something like that. We have a supervisory control system. We have a SCADA service that is devised that act as a SCADA master, MTU, master terminal unit, which is monitors and sends command to control devices and process. As well as, on the other hand, we have remote terminal units like PLC controller, which is used to generally take the field level. Like here we have temperature level, pressure level, we have oil level, we have some thermal threshold that we have measure, we have calculate, as well as it is designed to perform logical functions to execute some electrical hardware like relay, switches, actuators, valves, timers, whatever. It usually acts like a master-slave connection. So the remote terminal unit normally are devices, as well as it converts some signals from here, from the field, and transfer it to the master terminal unit to allow the user or whatever to be able to monitor or to see what is inside. So we have here the human machine interface, the HMI, which allow the user to be able to monitor, to see the field, how it is conditions, each and everything. We have, for example, a database, and we have a control system for that. Type, okay. We have three parts of SCADA that get attacked. The high level control room, which is like this. This high level control room contains the human machine interface. It is a window based. Here we can see some, for example, some pipelines, some tanks, some filters, some cyclones, some regulators, some valves. And this reflects the real image of the field. So if the actual valve is closed, it should be here closed as well. If it's open, should be open. The regulator system, how much it is open, 30%, 50%, should be indicated here. So this is the high level or the human machine interface that can monitor or give me an indication about the actual and real field, as well as the level, the medium level of attacks. Consider the wireless communication or wired communication. Sometimes we have to have some WiMAX, we have to have some ISDN, DSL connections to the stations. For example, if you have a pipeline for the gas pressure reduction station system, we have to have some valve rooms on this pipeline. These valve rooms should be connected to each other to allow the administrator or the user over there to be able to collect some information. I have to measure the pressure for each valve room to give me an indication of the continuity of the flow of this fluid, whatever it's gas, it's water, it's oil, whatever. So, and the low level, or the third part of our SCADA system that could be attacked, the low level, the endpoint control of physical assets by the remote terminal units, or the RTU, or for the programmable logic controls, or the PLC. See, we have here the PLC, this a PLC cabinet. I worked on PLC of Siemens Step 7. I worked on the human machine interface 1cc of Siemens as well. So here, for the PLC, you have to connect this pressure transmitter or temperature transmitter to the PLC. This connection here between this PLC and this transmitter, this digital gauge, is what we are considering. This is the Modbus communication. We are considering the authentication of this connection. So this is the probe. This probe is connecting to the pipeline, to the field. We'll get an analog signal to be connected to this digital gauge, and this digital gauge has a transmitter. It's connected with two wires communication channel to this PLC, and this connection is not secured. So far, yeah. Okay. So we are considering this kind of attack, the low level, the endpoint control physical assets. So the type of attack for the low level, it's at first a direct low level attack on the end affecting the hardware, like the remote terminal unit, affecting the programmable logic control. This kind of a tactic, the advantage of the weakness in the communication channel, or just you can plug some devices to a serial connection. While limited in scope, this kind of attack can disable critical pieces of some equipment that could affect the overall operation of the network. So here we have, for example, this is, you can say, a black valve. This is the flange of the valve. These actuators, this is a limit switch, this is a positioner. This actuator, if it is red, this means this valve is closed. This actuator is green, this means this valve is open. And this signal should be transmitted to the PLC to give me indication over the human-machine interface, as well as we can see here that this level gauge that give me indication about the level on this tank. It's 50%, 30%, it is this full. I have to open the drain, for example, have to take some action. All these signals should be transmitted over the Modbus communication. So here this is designed for the reliability, not the security. So far, this is the Modbus communication. So the Modbus is a digital communication protocol for two or more devices. It was designed 45 years before. It is designed to have some connection with the PLC, programmable logic control. It is a master-slave communication. It is the de facto standard communication protocol for connecting industrial and electronic devices. It's open source code. It's published, has been published by Modicon Schneider before. Now it's Schneider, it's Modicon before. It's easy to deploy and it's easy to be maintained. Okay. So how does Modbus work? It's a master slave devices. We have some master that pulls multiple slaves devices, like it's a master and this is slaves. Slave device cannot transmit information without a request from the master. Then the master keep the communication, he is controlling the communication, so it is centralized communication group. So data is sent in a series of zeros and ones, bits, packets of data. Okay, when I have to use a Modbus communication or a Modbus connection, when data is collected from multiple field of devices, we have centralized communication group. These, for example, these a valve, it is a transmitter, a pressure transmitter, these some flow computers maybe, and as well as when I have sufficient power on my hand, when sufficient power is available. So these are two conditions that I have to consider to use a Modbus communication. Okay, Modbus security protocol was designed with the maximum functionalities, but with a little attention to security. The Modbus attack can be categorized maybe in some categories like unauthorized command execution. Command could be unauthorized and authenticated. Modbus denial of service attack, man-in-the-middle attack, and reply attack. All of these kind of attacks, we have to countermeasure. We have to fix these kind of attacks by applying some authentication techniques. Okay, so on our approach, we have to have some interactability hard problems. We are utilizing the integer factorization problem and the discrete logarithm problem, and we are using the Chinese remainder theorem to broadcast some FRL private key. So we have the following. We have two prime numbers, B and Q, and is equal B multiplied by Q. We have two another numbers for the RSA algorithm, E and D are multiplicative inverse for each other, modulus the phi n, and we have G the generator for the prime number B and the prime number Q, and each RTU, each remote terminal unit, we have an identity for this remote terminal unit. It's modulus pairwise prime of co-prime modulus n, and we have a signature for this remote terminal unit SI, which is the RTU over minus D modulus n power over power minus D modulus n to be saved on the user device, and the authority, which is the master terminal unit, the MTU, usually used to broadcast this X to obtain the FRL private key for the communication. So this X is periodically broadcasted by the authority to all members to renew the entities or the FRL key. Okay, for the steady state operation, we have here the RTU want to encrypt some data or some comment to be executed by the master terminal unit. So we send this comment, we make it N because C will reflect the ciphertext. Here the RTU A select an integer H relative replying to the phi n, following pair are sent A and B, A RTU A to power minus D multiplied by the generator to power minus H modulus n, as well as B will contain the comment M, the plain text, multiplied by G to power E to power H to power RP, the private key broadcasted by the master terminal unit. The ciphertext is considered to be C like this, the pair of A and B. Then when the RTUP or the master terminal unit receiving this ciphertext will be able to obtain the plain text or the original command as before. So this is the execution. This is a message transfer like we have discussed before. It's one-way message. It contains a ciphered comment with the pair of A and B, and this will allow the destination to be able to calculate the comment as it is sent. So for the data origin authentication, we're evolving the identity of each RTU, for the identity for each remote terminal unit through the ciphertext, which guarantees the original authentication of the sent message. We consider here some intrader A who impersonating A to B and try to send some encrypted message to B. It is necessary for E to know either SA or D to find A of C like this. The freshness here, we are relying on the Chinese remainder theorem. We are relying on broadcasting this simultaneous congress X by the master terminal unit to guarantee the freshness. The confidentiality, no one can recognize the message from its cipher image without a knowledge of the destination private key, RI, and the trusted authority private key, D. This will make it is difficult for any intrader who tries to cryptanalyze the ciphertext with the integer factorization problem to get D plus the discrete graph problem to get RI. Because of this, we can say that our algorithm can provide the required confidentiality, the timelines, the instant message delivery is real time, one message, the size of message is limited, messages are executed in one conversation. So it's, regarding the timing, it's one message exchange. So finally, we have some conclusion with that regard. A new protocol secure Modbus communication protocol has been presented. Our algorithm stability difficulty depend on the integer factorization problem as well as the discrete graph problem. No one can disclose any information for the ciphered message. So far, what we are claiming, our algorithm achieves security requirement with no need to use an external security technique. But this is the conclusion. Some papers have been published with that regard before, but it has a very, very limited authentication technique using some XORing and some hashing. So we couldn't make the previous work here for the time being, but some techniques have been published, maybe in some good venues as well. So if you have any questions, please let me know.